大家可以今天可以进场来观看我们的颁奖仪式跟我们的比赛，然后未来我们各位会继续努力，希望抛下彩带的那一天可以让你们一起参与。
勇士队场均能够破百的得分，将比赛竟然只得了75分，
再度击败了富邦勇士，联盟的卫冕军打起来是倍感吃力啊。
目前排名第4，谁都不想要看到，可是我们就要得面对。
台北富邦勇士展现出来王者之师的风范，太可怕了，真的太可怕了。
这是一个去年能够夺冠的一个成熟球队打出来的内容。
最后富邦勇士就是108-104完成了在 Plusly 的2连霸。
在今年台北富邦勇士也再一次重金打造并且用心的手工制作，来要制作第2枚2连霸的冠军戒。而这个冠军戒待会大家也已经透过影片一起来回顾我们的夺冠的心路历程，也看到影片当中的戒指，待会我们就要来亲自由领队来颁发，也让我来为各位介绍。在戒指当中我们有看到我们年度的口号凭我相信 We Believe， 以及另外一面有一个 Bat to Bat 代表我们2连霸的意义。现在我们就要来一起欢迎我们台北富邦勇士篮球队领队蔡成儒 Chris， 欢迎领队。要借由今天的仪式，一起来感谢在上一季教练团队以及勇士们的辛苦。我们先请 Chris 来到场中，先来合影，跟冠军金杯一起合影。好 ，Chris 这边，好，好，先谢。我们看一下中间的媒体朋友，好看中间哦。好，谢谢，马上就要来邀请我们，邀请 Chris 来颁发的团队，首先是勇士教练团成员，让我们一起先来欢迎总教练许晋哲总教练。好，邀请 Chris 来颁发戒指给我们的总教练许晋哲。好，看前方，前方哦，好，再往前一步，谢谢。好，看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢。OK 吗？谢谢许总，谢谢。接着要来欢迎的是助理教练吴永仁教练。相信刚刚在看完影片之后，有在上一季陪伴勇士们一起争冠的都非常有感触，那今天也透过这样的场合一起来回馈给我们辛苦的勇士团队。好， OK 吗？谢谢，谢谢任教练。继续来欢迎助理教练林伟浩教练，掌声欢迎。好，一样看正前方。好，谢谢，谢谢韦浩教练。继续来欢迎助理教练魏维教练。好，看向前方。好，谢谢，谢谢魏维教练。接着来欢迎助理教练江志胜教练。好，看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢江志胜教练。继续来欢迎体能教练郑维轩教练。 好，看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢教练。接着来欢迎防护师林武章防护师。好，看正前方哦。好，谢谢，谢谢武装防护师。再来欢迎的是助理防护师彭玉明防护师。好，看前方哦，帮我看向前方。好，谢谢，谢谢玉明防护师。再来，我们要来欢迎的是球队翻译梁兆轩，欢迎 Avon。好，看前方哦，来看一下前方，谢谢。好，谢谢，谢谢 Avon。接下来欢迎的是勇士的球员们，首先让我们一起来欢迎赖廷恩。也看到勇士们身上穿着的冠军 T， 欢迎大家也可以到商品部一起来选购哦。来看前方，好，谢谢廷恩。接着让我来欢迎不只要冠军还要冰水的 P。好，来看向前方。OK， 谢谢，谢谢 Jones。继续来欢迎我们的喷射机张宗宪。好，来看前方哦，先来合影。好，谢谢宗宪，继续要来欢迎继续来成长逆流而上的周桂宇。好，来请桂宇还有 Chris 看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢桂宇，继续要来欢迎我们台湾的野兽杰哥林志杰。来，我们看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢杰哥。继续来欢迎我们的勇士我梦林梦雪。来看前方哦，看中间前方，谢谢。好，谢谢，谢谢孟雪。继续来欢迎我们勇士队长蔡文成。好，看正前方哦。好，谢谢，谢谢文成。继续来欢迎我们的 Final MVP Mike 新特利。好，来看前方。好，谢谢，谢谢 Mike。 继续来欢迎酷帅高人曾祥勋。来，祥勋看前方哦。好，谢谢祥勋。继续来欢迎我们的 Smart 石伯恩。 看前方。好，谢谢谢谢 Smart。接下来欢迎我们的张根玉。来，帮我看向前方哦。来看正前方。好，谢谢谢谢根玉。继续来欢迎我们的小峰赛瑟峰。好，看前方，正前方。好，那我们也请 Chris 还有小夫留步，马上要来请所有的教练团成员以及我们勇士的球员们一起来到场中，我们要来拍一张合影。同时在这边我要来有请我们富邦集团蔡明忠董事长来到场中一起来合影，欢迎我们董事长。好的，欢迎董事长也来到场中。好，还有我们的布条，我们要来一起拍一张冠军团队台北富邦勇士队的合影。好，帮我勇士球员帮我拉着布条。好，来看正前方喽，先看中间举手的，谢谢。好，谢谢，我们先请蔡明忠董事长先来回座休息，我们请队职员先留步，董事长先来休息，先回座，谢谢。我们请队职员先留着。好，再一张，我们请所有教练团队、领队、队还有队员一起来看前方。好，谢谢。接着我们也先谢谢领队以及教练团队，勇士球员请留步。那布条也帮我拉一下，拉好，对，还是要拉好，谢谢谢谢。请所有队友们一起拉好我们的冠军帆布条。来，如果还有手的帮我秀出你的冠军戒好吗？勇士们秀出来你们的冠军戒。好，再次掌声送给台北富邦勇士。那我们也请杰哥留步。还记得刚刚的影片中，是我们队长文成来跟大家分享喜悦，今年就由杰哥来跟所有现场的勇士球迷分享我们二连霸的喜悦。
前两季我们顺利完成了二连霸，然后非常感谢支持勇士的球迷们，谢谢你们。这一季目标当然就是三连霸，然后希望就是支持勇士的球迷们也可以继续为我们加，谢谢。
再次掌声送给林志杰。
现在介绍双方球员登陆名单，首先介绍客队新竹接口工程师。九一背后二号江广谦，三号林明义，四号高国豪，五号宋宇轩，背后七号曾博玉，十一号肖顺义，二十三号吕吉敏，二十四号郭少杰，先发球员背后八号前锋朱云豪，背后九号田浩，三十一号中锋阿提诺，三十五号中锋辛巴，三十六号前锋林怡威，总教练林冠伦，助理教练沈金汉、陈泽宇，像 Pierre Martin、黄胜富、黄富之、黄建元、防务员欧伯宏，总经理吴龙志，领队陈美玲。 球迷朋友们，全新的赛季只有我们能朝三连霸迈进，只有我们所以强大，都是经过无数的努力来达成。军队团结一心及球迷们的缺一不可，才能成为独一无二 One of One 的冠军队伍。而今天也将再次打造热血沸腾的勇士王朝。
经过那么多低潮，到底还撑什么？场上有人罩，需要这么努力吗？在台湾发展，真的有前途吗？黄金时代差不多了，有谁还在燃烧生命？
只有我们。
你问我撑什么？当然要继续撑吧。
三代联手才是最强阵。
You see these rings? That's why I'm here. We never fall back.
And you can find me where I'm at. We never fall
back.只要有我们，没有不可能。
One of One， 只有我们。台北富邦勇士的球迷朋友们，你们准备好了吗？现在介绍地主队台北富邦勇士队球员登陆名单，让我听到你们的尖叫声。首先欢迎勇士吉祥物皮尔。球衣队长球衣背号八号前锋勇士队鲑鱼 Number 8周桂宇，背号11号后卫左手怪杰 KJ 洪凯杰。
Gentlemen, seniors, and youth. Oh my PLG, you've made it to our opening day broadcast. We begin the third season with the two teams that left things off in season two. The two-time Plus League champion Taipei Fubon Braves against the top-seeded team of the last regular season, the Hsinchu Jeko Lioneers. If you were catching the broadcast earlier, the Braves presented their championship ring to the players, coaches, and staff, and I'm sure lots of the support staff will be getting their rings in the private ceremony. I'm Ryan Chen, your English play-by-play, as always, as you see the Braves sporting their championship t-shirts from last season. We have a lot of new additions on the roster, and they'll be taking on the Lioneers, who made some changes, but most notably have a few different imports that they will try out around Sim Bullard, of course, the import player of the year, led the league in points and rebounds. We're getting to enjoy the Braves pregame introductions, but soon enough we'll get to show off our Oh My PLG Season 3 graphics and visuals soon enough, which really exciting, really interesting, and sure very poppy. There you see Chris Johnson. He was the number one spotlight during the preseason stop down in Kaohsiung, as hosted by the now Kaohsiung 17 Live Steelers. You get to watch them tomorrow, if you so choose, if you will give us the pleasure of joining more broadcasts here in the Plus League. But Johnson showed off what he can do, even at the young age of a 37-year-old. Last year, the Braves took down the Lioneers 4-1 with a clinching game in Hsinchu. Overall, they were plus 53 points. Quite a big difference, but the first game had the Lioneers turn around as much as a 23-point deficit and gave the Braves a little bit of a scare in that clinching game, our first ever championship clinching moment in Plus League history, as our first season down in Zhonghua, the championship final series cut short due to COVID. Well, as we open things up in Taiwan and around the world, of course, be sure to practice safe hygienic practices. Well, we're here to enjoy some basketball. If you're on the television side, thanks for joining us. On the Mandarin broadcast, on the left is Sam He Shouzhen, and on the right is Mark Tionghui. 球迷朋友们，您找到了英文转播，谢谢你收看 Plus League 开幕战的转播。要看中文的，按当然按 YouTube 的中文连接。但谢谢你收看。 In addition to the English and Mandarin broadcast, you can also watch the B-League's Japanese broadcast as provided by Iguchi-san. Shout out to Chairman Shimane-san, Saito-san, and Ayumi-san, my counterparts, and of course, the chairman leading things off of that introduction. During the week, it was making some big news as the Braves revealed the upgrades they've had to the stadium. You can see through the windows at the two high-level VIP suites upstairs. And we might get a sneak peek of the locker rooms for the home team, the Braves, who made big renovations, installed lockers, and I think to the pleasure of the players as they had this pretty pedestrian locker
rooms.今年的嘉怡呢会担任场边的主播，当然就是要带大家来看到底在球场周围还有什么好玩的呢？那现在嘉怡人在的位置就是勇士主场啦。那今年的新球季，勇士为了要让各位球迷们有更好玩的，这什么地方？ 小勇士的游乐区，而且呢，这个空间它可以说是多功能的运用。像是在今天化身的就是游戏区，所以在嘉义的后方有大大的充气垫，然后可以让小朋友玩耍。那对于家长来说，其实来到这边就非常的方便啦。
That is our sideline reporter for today, a new addition to the broadcast, Ling Jiayi or Jiayi, giving us a preview of some of the additions for the Braves' home experience. Something, a little bit of everything for everyone. Of course, maybe imitating the team that they're going up against. The Lioneers do a great job providing entertainment for all different demographics, mainly age groups, and interests and activities. Of course, when the team was founded, they got to show off their locker rooms to the amazement of all. A lot of basketball insiders here in Taiwan, and they've continued building on that foundational success. And of course, Coach Greg leading the basketball side of things. He's increased his coaching staff, and after clinching the number one seed in the regular season, we've caught up with him pregame to see how they have approached the lead up into this opening day.
其实我们在球季的开始大概重点是在准备这四个洋将跟本土的配合，然后跟他们互相的配合，然后去找出对我们球队最好的化学变化。这是我们带上班机对这四个洋将的目标。非常全面，然后非常有智慧的一个球员。那他在 KBL 跟纽西兰，然后也拿过MVP的殊荣。那他回到台湾这边，然后跟我们加入团队训练，那感觉出来他在球商非常的高。
Giving you praise for high basketball IQ, leadership, and bringing some of that MVP pedigree from the KBL and the New Zealand League. And he's already put the word out that he'd like to see him up against Michael Singletary one day. Of course, the two-time finals MVP. not an easy task to do. One, because imports is a very, shall we say, flexible or influx situation for most of these teams. And we'll see it here. Even the Braves bring back two of their guys, mainstays of the teams in Singletary and Ior Zaitsev. Neither of those guys registered for this game. On the line near side, William Martino is registered for the game along with Sim. And Anthony Bennett still rehabbing a leg injury, so we'll look forward to his debut with the Lioneers after being a member of the Steelers team in their first season last year. On the other side for Coach Roger, he's already won championships at the other local league, the SBL, and now in the Plus League, has his Coach of the Year title and now two rings to his name. But there's been some roster fluctuations. We'll hear about it right here.
我想强化应该就是年龄吧，年龄平均年龄下降啦，因为大家去年的时候我们有老人岁，那今年势必又一样。那我们今年进来的六位本土的新秀，算是中生代也有，新人也有，所以我想平均年龄下降可以给我们更充沛的一个体力。那至于哪一部分要强化，我倒觉得应该数据部分啊，就是我们上一个赛季在三分线的命中率上面，例行赛的确非常低，还有罚球命中率。那我希望我们在这个赛季当中，人员的补强，我觉得非常好。那重点就是能不能打出很好的化学效益，在命中率上面能够有所提升。因为我们球队大概有三位嘛，小应该讲。志杰、文成跟中宪就是比较不希望他们吃太多的上场，因为大家都知道他们的年龄就是属于比较有经验的球员。然后我们如何在例行赛能够给他们比较受伤的一个时间控制，我觉得这算非常重要。那至于哪些球员，我倒觉得说能够把握到这场比赛，然后打得好的，那你就会继续去打。那这样时间你可能就会比较多。所以我希望每个球员都能够良性的竞争，然后上去之后争取自己的上
场。There's a lot of different changes to the Braves roster. They've picked two guys in the draft. They've made a trade, saying goodbye to longtime Brave Joseph Lin for KJ and Steve-O. They've also signed a couple guys from the SBL, namely the MVP from two seasons ago, Xie Zonglong.So as much as the Braves pride themselves on their depth, they only have 13 roster spots per game to allocate that. Meanwhile, for the Lioneer side, they have 16 players registered, of course, with that fourth import having to be seated for week-to-week registrations. Tohoming is the crew chief there in the middle in his second season.He'll be getting the opening day honors as the Golden Whistle winner from last season. It's time to bring you the starting lineup. First, the Lioneers from left to right, William Martino, Sim Bullard, number 8, Zhu Yinhao, Tian Hong, and Lin Yihui Ryan. Meanwhile, for the Braves, they'll be going with three bigs, Perry Jones, Chris Johnson, Jack Zhenxiangjun, and Zhang Zhongxian, the MVP of the first season, and...As predicted by Charles Chen, CEO of the league, number 0, Lai Ting-un, will now be running the point. One thing that happened very often was the combination of Joseph Lin and Jet as the starting backcourt for the Braves. As you see, a new photographer sitting in the stands, that's Byron Mullins.Of the new Taipei Kings. He's back with the team for a second season, looking fit. And of course, keep that photography practice up. Tai Mingzong is the chairman of the Fubon Group. responsible for throwing up this ceremonial tip. There it goes. We're just about ready to tip off. It is right now 5:12 p.m. local time here in Taipei. And the third season is off. Lioneers with starting with number 9 Tian Hao and bringing perhaps rookie of the year from two seasons ago Gao Guohao off the bench. Deep possession for Sim. He gets the two-handed slam and the scoring is started for the Plus League. Johnson on the handoff. Lightians counting this ball into the pavement. Johnson tries from three. It's good. What a response from the almost seven-footer for the Braves. Johnson's listed at 211 centimeters or 6'11". The Braves going with the zone against the Lioneers. That's well known. They're not the strongest three-point shooting team. That pass into a turnover. Right now a five-on-one, and they almost throw it away. Lioneers don't get back on defense, and there's a made bucket from the point guard. Quick trip down the other floor, and Sim Bular. Another 2 points. And any turnover or missed basket, it's pretty obvious that he didn't get back in a hurry, but on made baskets, as the other team has to bring it out from the baseline, he will hustle a lot harder. Jet will take a tough jumper and get the roll. Look that the teams are putting some points up as we get to talk about the different look of a scoreboard we have here in the Plus League across the bottom. Ryan gets a shot and drains it from the right side. Anyway, averaged the third most minutes for the Lioneers. Bounce in and out, and they're gonna say it's gonna stay with the Braves. Artino and Johnson, the two closest players. Lastly, Ling Wei averaged only 24% from three. Meanwhile, the Lioneers showing off a little bit of a zone themselves as Jones gets it off glass. Braves did have continue another high-powered offense, averaging the most at 98.7 points per game as Zurihal tries to get it back. Artino stopped by Johnson, takes the tough left hook. Too many bodies inside, and now they call 3 seconds. They had the height and the thickness to get that rebound, but Ryan couldn't get a shot off, and that's what length will do as we see Jones able to get it right over the outstretched arms of Sim. I think they're a little bit mixed up, the Lioneers, as they let that three. Open shot miss. Look to the basket, but a missed pass. Chance to run. And Sim commits the foul in transition. Got to be careful. Can be called it unsportsmanlike. Not that it's unsportsmanlike. That's just what we call it via the FIBA rulebook. Anyways, the Braves also had the highest offensive rating at 106.9. But defensively, they're not as strong as their first season in third place for points per game and defensive rating. Right, Ian sidesteps into a flanker. Transition up ahead, Ryan. Junior Hall, who tries to get it between two. There's Sim, pushing his way in. Couldn't get it on the second try, and finally Jones comes down with a rebound. Right now the Braves have an advantage in the transition play. Jet flies through and can't get it, and a little foul from behind on the rebound. kind of the line your style of play. They need their backcourt players to really do more than just average defensively in transition, as anyone between Artino, Simbular, or even Bennett, and of course, Lin Yihui, not exactly the most fleet of foot. They're only down by three. Have an inbounds play. Lions, though, they know, Lioneers know how to finish strong in the regular season. Easy opportunity. Dorian Hall bounces that one. This time the Lioneers get back. Johnson in the post. Takes a spinning shot and hits it. That makes the Braves 4-for-9 to open the game. As there's another turnover, no one to beat as Lytium will lay it in for two, and this packed house is letting them hear it. No substitutions yet. As Zhen Xiangju committed the foul first. Got away with a kick ball, but the referees say incidental, and it's 2 points the other way. Here's our first substitution of the game. Coming in for Xiangjun, the aforementioned MVP of the SBL, Xie Zhongrong. That was 2 years ago. As Sim slams it home on the inbounds play. The Lioneers are very strong at that. ITM might be little, but he does have that range from outside. Jet finding some room to Johnson. There's a two-handed slam. Nice find. In the midst of crowd by Jet. Shia Donlo previously played with the Bank of Taiwan Trust Team. Zhong's having a good effect as there's deflection. Another steal and Zhang Zhongxian this time. 2 points via Lai Tingen. That buzzer must be our first time out of the game as the Taipei Fubon Braves have jumped out to an early lead. Oh my PLG, we've begun this third season of the Plus League. Be back after these messages.
Come, 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 师傅来了，比尔，比尔，你要做一个示范动作，才可以让勇士的伙伴们跟着你。目标 ，OK OK， 想要学猫叫就对了，比尔。被拍到的朋友，来，这位美女跟着比尔一起学猫叫，谢谢你，不要害羞，不要害羞，之后我们 copycat 都要来跟着比尔，来，这位小弟弟跟着比尔一起来，比尔换个动作，哦，秀出你的肌肉，弟弟秀出你的肌肉，很好，很好，很好，来来来，下一位美女 ，hello。送飞吻，比尔，人家已经做动作了。可以可以。
Welcome back to the broadcast. As
好看的画面，再来再来，下一位美女，比尔，下一题，下一题。
The mascot for the Taipei Fubon Braves.
秀肌肉，秀肌肉，对对对，秀肌肉，不要误会。好，这一位鲑鱼的铁粉，
来就是你，来来来，
要比什么动作？哦，鲑鱼逆流而上，跟着比尔一起逆流而上。
Right now, in the early goings of this one.The Braves lead things
18-9.
And predictably, plenty of those points have come in transition. Right now, Johnson leading the pack with 7 points. Simbular 6 lead the Lioneers.
Of course,
been efficient with shooting.
In
large parts thanks to Sim. But they've already committed five turnovers. Last year in the regular season, the Lioneers, the Braves, along with the Formosa Taishin Dreamers and the New Taipei Kings made it into the playoffs. The biggest difference in games behind was four. That was the Kings to end the season. Not in great form. Looks like no substitutions for either team as Willie Martino is fouled in the interior. So across the bottom, the three long dots under Braves is their team foul count in the quarter. Lioneers only have one. Inside to Artino. He's fouled on the drive. Looks like she had done well once again. Nice crisp passing. Can beat any defense. And of course, if you're throwing the ball away, that's going to lead to easy points for the other team, as another local big in Ling Mengxie will check into the game. There's Brennan Smart. What they would often do is play Smart in the second and fourth quarters. A little back screen for Sim, but it doesn't open up. Martino with some energy up to Sim, who gets the slam. So tall that he kind of stuffed it in there. Mengxie not an apt scorer himself. Johnson in the corner. Who would try to go through the basket. That's not going to work. Chance for the Lioneers to run. Cross matched up, Artino depositioning, left-handed hook, no, Sim will finish with two. A little bit too much body for Chris Johnson to handle. Lioneers will run their zone more often than not. Mengxie from the top balances that one out. Something out. Big passes, skip passes. Tianhao misses from three, though. Little guard average only 31% on 41 attempts. Time for Jet's turn. His set shot, no. The Braves have not scored in about 3.5 minutes now. Martino trying to get inside. Looks like he's going to be called for travel. Going to have I guess the tricky thing is for Martino making a case to the referees. He was trying to drive against two defenders, and when those number games don't work in your favor, it's kind of hard. Here you see Beast will check into the game, number 12. Voted the All-Plus League second team. He's checked in along with number 8, Josh Sokoyu. So those two are in the proverbial backcourt. As Jones tries to get to the rack and scores on another tough bank shot. There's a score we haven't seen in a while. For the Braves. Lioneers, meanwhile, starting to go a little smaller. Artino at center. Oscar's in, along with number 11, Xiao Sunyi. Artino's arc is out. That's the funny thing about Beast. He's kind of a showman when he rebounds, too. Josh picked up the dribble a little too early. Now Duyao trying to close off the space on Jones. Trying to get the skip pass and off the foot of Li Mengxie. Got a new hairstyle. He's now, I believe, the longest tenured Brave now after Joseph Lynn has departed from the team in that trade. And you see Jones now is, proverbially speaking, we say the word 吃, or to, I guess, engulf, to eat. That's what we say here in Taiwan about taking your man one-on-one. Mioneers ping-pong the ball around. Tianhao is trying to find a teammate. Oscar will get his first shot of the season and nail it. Oscar also named to the Plus League defensive team. Coming off a better three-point stroke. 36% as little oopsie do as Winston scores underneath. No looking pass. Zunihan will try again from the corner. In and out though, as Artino battles his way to a rebound. Now Beast muscling his way to the hoop. He'll get the foul. Here we see Oscar loses his man in that weird dribble drive screen. Jones will get his first rest spell of the game as Johnson will check back in. Beast at the free throw line. I believe this is the first time in the game. Johnson scored a total of 48 points in his two preseason games. But the man at the free throw line, basketball fans around Asia might be familiar with him. Beast didn't even suit up during the preseason. Junior Hall will take a seat. Number three, Li Mi of the Lioneers. They're going small with Sim at center. Three guards. Oscar get a chance from the left corner and a beauty. Johnson from the elbow, too strong with it. Fancy pass as Winston goes for the runner and got it. Six to 19, 100 seconds left in the first quarter. Josh, good defensive positioning. The position for Sim, three guys come over and Beast with the rebound. Chance in transition, though he almost loses it. Trying to make lemonade out of lemon, but Winston misses at the hoop. Sim running early, a chance and a foul by Smart. Here's number 11, Xiao Sun Yi, who's kind of the local big for the Lioneers. More so a 3 or 4 player. Talk about the king of awkward and odd-looking shots. That's number 14, the captain for the Braves, is Winston. That's when he dunks that free throw out. The Lioneers have done a much better job. They've only committed one turnover since that timeout. An 0-for-2 trip. That can't be good for, I guess, the psyche of Lioneers fans as the team. One of the lowest free throw shooting teams in the league. In fact, only 63%. Let's see if they can improve on that this season. Smart kind of got in trouble there. It's going to say a turnover on the Braves. Good active hands. Number 23, Ru Jiming, or Mickey. He's also listed at guard, about 188 centimeters. Drives to the hoop, has that one erased by Johnson. Josh to the rim and scores over the much smaller Ling Ming Yi, and one coming up. Good play by Mickey, but ran into the high-flying Johnson, who showed it off on the defensive end. And Josh Sokoyer, he's a much better finisher at the rim. Later in the second season, we see preseason in this first game. Kind of struggled with that in the first season. Can't hit the bonus free throw. Maybe a couple possessions left. Number eight, that's KJ, Honkai J. He was in the... No, that was Josh, excuse me. Number 11 is Honkai J. Came over in the Joseph Lynn trade. They say it was a pass out of bounds by the Lioneers. Smart guarding that back line. Executing late in the shot clock, late in quarters. It's the strength of the Braves, especially with Beast on the floor, but it's Johnson with the jumper, no good. And somehow had enough airtime to save it inbounds, but it's the Lioneers. Oscar from way downtown. It'll plank off the backboard. That does it for the first quarter as the Braves jumped out to a lead of the Lioneers. Have their chance to get reorganized before we start the second quarter. You're watching a Plus League Basketball. Watching the Plus League, however you watch it. If it's on YouTube, be sure to leave a like on all of our streams. Fubon Angels, the cheerleaders for the Taipei Fubon Braves, showing off a new look and, of course, taking an important role in the pregame ring ceremony. See the Muse girls or other cheerleader squads in future broadcasts. All part of the experience. So after the first quarter, Lioneers with 19 points, 10 of them via the man on your screen, Sim Bular. With 9 shots taken, that leads the team. And only 3 players scored, in fact. Ling Yihui, Sim, and Oscar's 2 threes. Bad pass, and it's a turnover. former Brave 郭少杰 to get credit for the steal. Now in transition, left open. His shot is good. That's a quick way to get back in the game. Meanwhile, for the Braves, seven players have scored. Dangerous pass, and KJ get it back. Johnson again from the middle, this time answers with two. Showing off the three, and he's shown off some touch from the mid-range. Something of a starting lineup with Artino, a forward and two guards, gets it off glass. Martino is now on the scoring board. Last season played in another league in Taiwan and was able to average 26 points and about 11 rebounds per game. Johnson from much deeper this time, in and out. Shit, Zolo gets the rebound from the up high. Looking down the floor, Oscar. We need Artino. The Braves get back in defense. Now a horn set, but Johnson got a hand on it. A little bit of rough play though, as the Lioneers get it back. And a missed dunk. And a foul from behind by Jones, so a net positive, really, for the Braves. Only give up two free throws in the transition play. Sim kind of psyched himself out, or Shizong did something to that, and Jones with a hard enough foul. Just with that free throw. Well, we're keeping an eye on that. The Lioneers 0 for 3 to start the game. Now 0 for 4. Last year during the playoffs, they also were the lowest ranking team at only 66% from the line. There's a made bucket from the mid-range by Josh. So far, he played on Chinese Taipei in a FIBA qualifier in Japan, where he was had a little bit of a scoring matchup against Nishida. There's another three by that's Guo Shaojie, or simply J. Now KJ from the corner, and Shi Zhonglong is showing off his length and knows for a rebound, but Lioneers will have Oscar to Martino, and they call a travel on him. That's gonna be kind of rough in transition. Jet will come back in the game. Not a very long stint for KJ, still working himself into the lineup, so starting backcourt for the Braves is out there. Given space, number zero misses to the left. Only a 4-point deficit for the Lioneers. They've done better on defense. Oscar taking his time, popping a shot. It's in for two. That buzzer is the Braves calling timeouts. Need to get reorganized and sort things out on offense.
帅哥拿着根玉的很吸引我，还有没有？站起来，让我看一下你想参加游戏的热情好吗？来，我让弟弟尝试一下。来这边的朋友，我就往后丢了。
好，拿到小球朋友，六位参赛者记得在第二节结束来到两边的篮筐后方集合，谢谢。
End of time out， 暂停时间到。
This week we're opening the season at Taipei Heping Gymnasium, but you can see Byron Mullins and others, other Plus League teams open up their home weekends. Next week it's the Dreamers and the Kings will be making their season debuts and their, of course, home debuts. Some excited fans and stands. Tickets still available for the Kings games on the IBON networks.Great to see a full house for our opening game. And we, of course, love to see full houses every game. Though, of course, understandably, it's a long season. Each team now gets to have 20 home games during the regular season. So it's a chance for more sponsors to come in. It's a chance for different fans who maybe not had the chance to get a taste of Plus League basketball in person. Jet takes a difficult two and drains it. Had a little bit of a down year last season, but was dealing with a lot of nagging injuries. Actually missed some time without his good friend Joseph. Let's see how Jet fares. Artino forced into a miss. The rebound eventually falls to the Braves.Yeah, getting the foul, putting it up. We'll go to the line. He's one spot that the Lioneers right now are kind of struggling with. His full court dribble, his penetration in the half court. That's kind of the risky run, though, at the same time for the Lioneers trying to run two guards. You need your forwards to match up. And, of course, if you have both import bigs, it's kind of hard for...one of your guys to find Jet in transition, especially. Missing with that free throw. Jet averaged 12 points, 2 rebounds, 3 assists per game last season. One for two at the line.One player who stood out in their playoff split versus the regular season was Beast. 15 points per game after 11 points per game in the regular season. Oscar with the runner, and Sim steps it back in. It's kind of that amplifier effect when he scores and then hustles back on defense. It kind of works both ways. Johnson from the high post over to Jones.Lighting up from deep. Foul from behind by Jones. Fans, if you've been paying attention to basketball in Taiwan during the offseason, there was the interleague competition where William Martino played for the Chinese Taipei Development Team. While he already had his contract with the Lioneers, and the Lioneers also participated in that competition, so...There's a lot of inside jokes about taking it easy, but not taking it easy. Sim Buller, oh my PLG. Who is that dime by? I think it was Guo Shaojie. Might have taken a shot there. Sim Buller doubled over, still able to get the board. With possession, looks like they'll...have a replay review of that. Credit to him for grabbing the rebound. Now Coach Greg indicating to the referees, maybe it's worth taking another look at. The only player around was Brendan Smart. Don't know what was going on there. But by the fact that Smart missed the jumper, I don't know if that's indicative of something or if it's indicative of nothing. You can be the judge of that. But for any player that's injured, the referees do have the opportunity presented to them to review the play. Right now, I'm going to say nothing going on, no review either, as Gorsalje with that high rainbow. Smart. Count out Jump Johnson. Jet in transition. Call a foul on Tian Hao, who used his shoulder to stop the break. Martino is kind of right now manning the top of the zone. Actually got his hand on that one. An interesting look. Yeah, we'll try again from three. Smart. Can't get the rebound down. And a couple quick turnovers, perhaps, by both teams. Tianhao, nice handles to the rim. And Martino able to finish. That was a mouthful. But now the Lioneers taking their first lead of the game after the first score. Johnson to Jet, who's missed a couple times outside, to the other side. Wow, getting the English. They say it's a turnover. Jet had a part in it. Get another look at this one. He knew he was going to go to the other side, and I clipped on the arm, too. Probably would love to take inventory as he's kind of twitching his eyes there. Dead again to the hole. Smart on the left side, but misses the close one. Oscar, another runner. That one's off the back iron. Shot fake, and Jet with a quick push shot. Almost had it. This time, air balls it from mid-range. What is going on with the eye? And the Braves staff is not going to give him any breaks. Gonna be Winston in for Jones. Jones was a later addition to the Braves, and in fact made his an important game played against the Lioneers when Michael Singletary was suspended for a game. They could only play one import. Actually had a pretty close game against the Lioneers. They're upping the pressure on the perimeter as Lee played. Nice spin move, but that one on the floor. Martino finds it, missing the layup. They're going to say out of bounds off the Lioneers. That popped into a couple opportunities, but can't finish. Much better defense in this second quarter. Braves only have nine as Martino bumps Jed and sent him to the line. Taking a look at the fouls, Tianhao has two. But on the other side, it's just Perry Jones with two fouls. I don't know how much you can believe it, but Jet calls himself the free throw machine. Watch out, one free throw, stand up, one more. Mimi's back in the game. In for Oscar. Positive minutes for number four. Now with a zone look. behind the back fancy. Have a shot from the left side. Got it. Mountaineers tie things up at 39. A much improved second quarter. Johnson from the top rattles it home. That makes him 2 for 2 from the outside. And a travel call by Yihui. Not having a great start to the season. There's the famous beast jump pass, even kind of shook off our left side high camera. In the plus lead, we employ 6 active cameramen, 2 on the baseline, 2 on platforms high. Your main camera, right, you see here, and a close-up cam. And then the 2 automated ones behind the basket. Mountaineers convert to pick up that rebound. Martino from deep. Wow, butter. After made baskets, this is Martino up top. Sim Bular in the back line. Now the Braves are having trouble with spacing as in and out by Beast. Mountaineers definitely don't mind slowing the pace down. Take advantage of Sim Bular there, but that one got a hand on it. Transitions the game for the Braves as Jet lays it in for 2. Got to get back quick. Braves able to defend in transition. A little 4-on-4 going. Winston just flings it up there. Johnson finishes it with 2. Sensing the energy in the building. The Lionheers call timeout. That's the tenacity you got to play with in this league where, as might have seen, a healthy amount of contact going on the floor. You see Winston can make the circus shots, but also knows when to put it up. Johnson too lengthy even for 7-foot Will Artino there. Now during the regular season, give you a little peek as how competitive it was last year. All the playoff teams, the Braves, the Lionheers, the Dreamers, and the Kings, they've had leads as the number one team. And it wasn't even only a 1 week blip either. A little bit of a peek into the Lionheers timeout.
Hey, keep moving the ball, be rotation. That one helps. We need local, drive, read, kick out. Well, outside, inside. Okay, ma, hey, 一定会有. Okay, game situation. Points up and down, fine. 44 points, no problem. Okay,
one thing that Lionheers keep encouraging their teammates is for the locals to be aggressive, take the ball to the basket, see if they can create an opportunity. So as I was saying, Braves had number one spot for 6 weeks, or shared spot for number one. Kings for 7 weeks. Lionheers for 7 weeks. The Dreamers for 8 weeks. Up until week 12, and of course, they had the best home record. Johnson, 14 points, 5 rebounds so far in the game. Now, the only 2 teams that we've not mentioned, the Power and Pilots, seen a big-time youth movement with that team. And the Steelers, of course, signing in a number of local free agents in addition to swapping a lot of their imports. Little horn set. Martino from top. Good with the jumper. Oh, A little too hot for Winston, and he pokes it out of bounds. A bit of a two-for-one opportunity for the Lioneers here. Lioneers were had a taste of number one as they have a foul off ball. Sim and Xie Zonglong. But through the middle of the season, the Lioneers were only treading water right around 500. So they went on a 11 win in 12 games. Strong end to their season, of course, clinching the number one spot. The season, of course, extended by some of the COVID infections and delays we've had in play. Martino up close, able to body Johnson, but Jones comes over for the help. They bounced it around and right into a turnover. Johnson spinning, Zuringhal getting to the rack with the foul. He'll go to the line. I don't know if anybody wants to give Chris Johnson a ring. That's a seven-footer with a little bit of handles. Going left and right, switching sides. I guess the only thing left is a little bit of that left-handed finger roll finish. Four team fouls for the Lioneers, only three for the Braves. 92 seconds left. It looks like free throw shooting for both teams starting to become a little bit of an issue. With those two. And now the Lioneers are plus six in the second quarter. Almost with a travel there now with a nice feed and a foul from behind. Zhen Xiangjun didn't get his money's worth on that one. Well, when it comes to big play, two hands on the body is something the referees are going to be talking about. And definitely see it there. The left hand is what you want to keep an eye on. Maybe you can push up against, but you can't hold from behind. Of course, officiating is a big component that a lot of people have been talking about. You wish to see the plus league improve on. With the help of leading the way, of course, is Mr. Lin Lingjinglong.
Xiangjun, so should be someone have to steal.
You know, listening to the Brave time at this time. See what the Braves have in their playbook. I don't imagine they've ever thought about facing a 1-3-1 with a center up top and a center down low.
You just follow the ball. 从三分球外进来，志杰这边进去。 所以中线你要去选，这边要拉开，看要不要给他，给 P 变定点射手，志杰这边，中败，成功就继续走，好，哎，来 ，Let's go，Let's go，上半场要保持领先进去啊，来，喂
，Of course, the plus leagues has employed commissioned J.B. Caldwell as the officiating consultant. The second year of collaborating with Mr. Caldwell. There's also been changes to other elements, such as our stats keeping, as revealed in the Plus League press conference, Synergy Stats. Different from what we've had previously. Sim Bullard's line, 18 points and 10 rebounds. Less than a half of work. Back to Beast, though he takes the shot, fake, then throws it up. Johnson, got to have quite a bit of core strength to get that one. Miscommunication on the pass. Now the Lioneers with a chance for a 2-for-1. Right at 47. Tianhong controlling, looking for Artino to get it to him. Tianhong with a couple fouls, erased by Johnson. A second and very impressive block. The defense a little bit off as Perry Jones finishes over the top. Feed by Johnson, he's doing everything today. Like we're gonna have a whistle first, though. A little bit awkward, but theoretically, the referees can stop the game for whatever they deem as a reason to stop the game. It could be a foul on the floor, of course, the typical thing that happens. Well, maybe the referees might take a look at that block shot for possible goaltending. Johnson gets a tough rebound from three-quarters court. Gets it on rim, but no good. Twenty-four minutes in the books. 24 for the second half of our opening game here in the Plus League's third season. Thank you for watching. We'll be going to halftime, a couple analysis breaks in the middle. Well, we'll see you in a bit.
差点进了那一颗，没关系，我们先请投给强生的，不要急着上厕所，忍耐一下。我要请比尔来抽出奖项，今天要送什么呢？要送给三位朋友，可以获得每个人可以获得用我们大同所提供的最强除湿机6公升1级效能除湿机。第一位朋友，第一位朋友，恭喜是5135，5135，但是。 他的两张都在我手上，所以基本上这是无效的，重来，谢谢他。下次要记得一半留在自己身上哦。来，第一位4144，4144，4144。第二位2285，2285，2285。第三位5123，5123。以上三位。 4144，2285，5123，赶紧来到两边篮筐后方，我们要再一次的，待会在中场游戏结束后要来颁奖。好，谢谢庆庆，谢谢比尔，还有李才悍将。那么在接下来呢，刚刚我们赛前我们重量级来宾欧仲就跟大家预告了，中场他们还会带来一场很棒的演出，准备好跟他们谈恋爱了没？ 现场，让我们再次欢迎欧仲。Hello
Hello，
有。越来越爱，越来越坏，越来越坏，不想。
想承认你是我的蔡秋文。I just want you baby， 和你制造回忆，太空说要飞起，带你飞到银河系去。其实一人也不及你，只是我在你的爱。
Two points is the difference between the Lioneers and the Braves after one half of play.Sam Hoseldzin and Mark Tianhongkui on the Mandarin broadcast. I'm Ryan Chen here providing the English commentary. And if you're so curious, you can say hello to Higuchi-san over on the Japanese broadcast. You can check them out. B.League for the B.League YouTube channel streaming this game. There's the combined team statistics for the...Lioneers have the edge in rebounding, 25-22. They've also passed more assists, but of course those early turnovers is what gave the Braves their early lead. But then the Lioneers started changing up their defensive strategy and definitely slowed the pace down a little bit in the second quarter to close the gap and in fact take the lead in a few occasions.Sim Bullard remains, of course, perhaps the biggest influencer and impactful player. So for the Braves, getting out in transition and shooting on the perimeter is going to be the crucial thing for them. In fact, at least in the first half, they only hit 3 of 11 threes. They haven't even taken as many as the Lioneers, who are 7 for 16.Making two of them is Oscar and Gulsalje, both guys coming off the bench. So that's a positive sign if you're the Lioneers, and maybe something to consider when it comes to their second half rotations. Remember, you can only play one import player on the floor in the fourth quarter, so the dynamics change a little bit. Maybe, in fact, both guys will see more playing time in the second half.It's a little bit surprising that the Braves don't have more assists in the game. Almost all of them have come in transition. They're usually supposed to be a little bit more free-flowing offense in the half court, but with the departure of Landlord, you won't get such money crisp passing in the half court. We'll be bringing you the...top scorers in the next segment. Of course, Jet is right now the local standout in terms of scoring. But Chris Johnson has shown off he can do it all defensively, scoring the basketball, and even throwing dimes. Harry Jones right now 3 for 3 so far. We'll be going to another breakAfter I tell you the leading scorers, Sim Bullard with 18, Artino with 9, Oscar with 8. Gulsalje hit a couple three-pointers for 6 points, and starting the game, Li Yihui, he had 3 points in the first half. On the other side, Chris Johnson with 15, Jet Zhang Dongxian with 13, Jones with 6, Bai Tina with 5, he got the start today, and Josh Zhougui had a couple layups. Now it's time for our break before the second half after this.
来到中间。
这一次是奔放黑球衣对上我们战队粉红的球衣，来喽，定位，仔细听音乐
，One Two Ready Go
Go Go Go， 来，我们先让开，先让开，小心小心，这边还有板子，把板子帮我丢到前面一点，谢谢，让他们比较好翻，加油加油。好，都还没有，加油！野兽，哎，恭喜配对成功！我没看到那一片，抱歉抱歉。恭喜我们 Mike 的粉丝获胜了！来来来，获胜的站我这一边好不好？来，获胜的靠近我，来，谁来这边？来，获胜的三位，那差一点的没关系，到左手边，我们一起来合影。来，比尔带着理财悍将，来来来，到中间，来看前面哦，来，我们靠近一点。好，看前方，来看前方 ，OK 吗？谢谢你们，谢谢。来，我们到场边休息，谢谢哦。再来，要来颁发的是刚刚我们神预测的三位得主，可以获得我们由大鹏品牌提供的最强厨师机。来，好，三位一起看前方，来来来，先看前方摄影师哦。中间举手的那一位，好，谢谢谢谢，来我们后面领奖哦，谢谢。来，厨师机要记得带走，来来来，
收看 Plus League 线上的四万名球迷们，大家好，我是今天的场边主播，我是嘉怡。好啦，那很开心来到二二跟二三的新球季。其实两点三十分现场就可以看到非常多人，而且今天可是满场哦。而且勇士呢，其实在今年其实为了主场也耗费了心力，那可以看到很多的元素，包括了之前曝光的主队的休息室啊 ，VIP 的包厢，还有儿童游戏互动区。那当然主题曲也是煞费苦心。那马上呢，嘉怡要欢迎的是我们富邦勇士的啦啦队的团长 Travis， 还有 Kevin。好啦，那当然要先让大家了解一下，在这一次的主题曲，明天主场才会第一次的曝光。可是 Travis 非常用心，对不对？
哦，对，这一次我们也是从选曲啊，然后写曲，然后写词，在当中我们加了很多明显的元素，包含提到的野兽啊，还有喷射机，还有小跑车，很多球员，希望大家听到就可以有那个画面在想象。然后当中我们还有一段是结合了过去的口号串在一起，让大家可以听得更有共鸣。
对，其实勇士球迷一定会听得出来啦。那当然 Kevin 也讲一下，这一次的主题曲是你跟 Travis 还亲自的配唱，对不对？来讲一下有趣的画面好了。
好，最有趣的部分就是因为我是第一次录音进录音室，然后才知道原来真的不简单。不简单在哪里呢？就是我两个八拍录了两个小时，哎，而且我是唱这个低音的部分，然后进去之后呢，我一直唱原 key， 然后老师一直纠正我，然后我后来才导正唱的低音的部分，
所以找很久了。
对，所以呢也请大家稍微的期待一下，那我们勇士主场主题曲在明天主场会第一次公布，那接下来就请大家继续享受下半场的比赛吧。
Well, they worked really hard. We worked really hard to start the season. We'll be going to break the second after this. Here you see the happy people talking in amongst the elevated experience here at Heping Gymnasium. It's, of course, taken a little bit of time. We've also been told that those VIP boxes are available for per game rents. Well, Chris Johnson, after we explained the high output of scoring in the preseason, he's shown off the skill, and he's also shown off how well he's worked himself into the team's game plan on both ends of the floor. And the Braves, you can say they're doing a decent job when it comes to corralling Sim Bular, but 18 points on 13 shots. Not bad efficiency, though they've only sent him to the line a couple of times. So in some ways, in of itself, that's a victory. But the Lioneers, at the same time, have done a good job slowing down the Braves' transition game. And a huge key to that, of course, as I mentioned, and always will be an important thing, keeping down those turnovers, those live ball turnovers, are always going to be a killer. Well, Tian Hao dribbling against Lai Tingen. This looks like both teams have their starters with Oscar in. But Lin Yihui starts the scoring off, and that three gives the Lioneers the one-point lead. Jones, Johnson, Winston, Lai Tingen, and Zhang Zhongxian. So both teams making a little bit of an adjustment as that one's airballed. Running a little low on time. Jet driving on Oscar. The tough side fade shot as Oscar now doubled over. Kind of working something off that ankle. He didn't do very much to contest the shot. Get another look at what happened there. Looks like that right ankle turned up against Jets. Hopefully it's not too big of a deal. Keeping up and active will prevent that swelling from getting any worse. Looks like he's good to go, though. He does have that grimace on his face. Given a couple steps by Jet as Tian Hao hot free for the second, back to Oscar, and he drains the shot. Well, that's a two-for-two start from the Lioneers. Jones out to Jet, this time from the right side. He hits the three. Though a combined 4-for-4 start. That's certainly what the broadcasters like. Haven't seen it too much so far. Of course, it's opening game. Martino trying to work on Winston, and there's a foul first. Down low before he got a shot off. Well, the Braves had 351 players participate in their games last year. That's the most of any team in the league. Kind of showing off their depth, but also showing off how they like to rotate guys. Down low for Sim. Too strong, then stuffs it in for two. Well, the Lioneers are second with 349. Players rotated in. Johnson over to Jones. His arc is in. Interesting, because maybe more traditionally you might have Johnson into the dunker spot, but they have him in the high post and Perry Jones on the perimeter. Martino. Call for traveling again. And it looks like he's going to get teed up. that'll be the first one of the season for anybody. And that honor goes to William Martino. The only thing I can offer for one of the newer members of the Lioneers is that the Plus League game is very physical, and so maybe not getting the call is one thing, but then calling a turnover, understandably, kind of hard to take. To Winston in the corner, he already airballed the last shot. This time makes the correction for three. Catching the Lioneer snoozing there on defense. Braves in man defense. Trying to make space for Oscar. He's got Jet defending. And a Simbular fadeaway. Nothing to sneeze at. Simbular is a pretty good three-point shooter, of course, with his feet set. Backdoor as Winston just barely getting on iron. Try to get a little too fancy with that reverse layup. Pass intercepted, and here's a transition. Martino fouls, stopping the break. I mean, it's a very difficult thing to do to lure a bad entry pass by the Lioneers, but really, when you have Chris Johnson and Perry Jones, it's entirely possible, as you see. Johnson was behind Sim as his arm went forward to cause the deflection. Still the starting group for both teams, at least in the second half, as Winston pushes it up. Two bounces and out. A little bit of foul. Lightingen. This pace definitely favors the Braves, as right now they're up 12-8 on the quarter. Down to Sim, but a little bit too far out. Will Martino with a hard archer. And Perry Jones eventually collects it. Jet avoids two, puts it on rim, no good. Tim Hall somehow gets it on and gets it in. A little bit of a track meet there as Johnson thought about it. Jones will try from three and splashes it. Perry Jones hit 14 of 24 threes, so not a huge sample size, but 58% from beyond the arc, as there's a foul in the corner by Winston. Oh, so much for that momentum. Kind of spoiled by the poor contests by the captain, number 14. Kind of lazy too, because Ryan Linhui is a right-handed shooter. Winston could have easily flown by him. Got the free throw count and caused the miss. So far in the game, Linhui 2 for 2 from the outside, so you maybe can explain why Winston could test him so hard. They're legally getting off the rim. Lighting with all day long, missing that three. A quick one and done. They ping-ponging around. Linhui to the basket, blocked from behind, it seems. A little 5-on-3. Winston steps through and lays it in. Right now, this lineup is working for the Braves as Jones fouls from behind. Put in a pretty decent effort, but they say he fouled from behind. The first time out in the second half as the Braves have regained control and lead by a few possessions. Our first break in the second half. You're watching Plus League Basketball. Angels perform, leading into the return of basketball after the first time out in the second half. Tomorrow, the Braves giving away the Season 2 Championship ring, of course, fan editions, to you, the fans in attendance. Just a few tickets available on the Braves ticket site. Of course, you got to search Taipei Fubon Braves. As we left off, it was a 66-58 game where the Braves have already got 17 points on the quarter, closing in on that 21 mark from the second quarter. You see Ibaka on the left and Tirico White on the right. Literally a couple of men in black outfits. But no suit and tie, though. That'll be interesting to see if any Plus League player will show up sitting on the bench in a suit and tie. After hitting the first free throw, Sin's got another one coming up after the Perry Jones foul in transition. A little bit more traditional 2-3 defense by the Lioneers. Over to Jet. His three is no good. Contest by Will Artino. And now in transition, Lin Yihui throws it away. Jones back to Jet, who's missed a few from outside now. Takes the tough jumper off to the left. Not great transition play by the Braves after I praised them all game. That's for the Lioneers now in the half court. A couple Braves trying to check in. Minghui with all day, but shot blocked by the imports. Jet trying to get to the other side and lays it in. Oscar with the foul. Stop on one and leads the transition on the other. A story old as time. Hey, Lin Yihui stopped by Chris Johnson in front, and Jet did the rest. He's listed at guard, but Jet Zhang Zhongxian is, by the paperwork, 192 centimeters, so not an easy task for the 179 centimeter Oscar to stop in transition like that, going back. Adding to the challenges for the Lioneers, Beast is checking into the game. Only only 2 points at the free throw line. As Oscar missing with that three. Bad transition play by the Braves again. This time a turnover. Winston wasn't looking. Martino closing the gap. Left-handed hook shot, no good. And another intercepted pass by Johnson. That time Perry Jones was the defender in the back. And a foul by Guosaojie. It was a little bit of an odd timing. And now the Lioneers want to call timeout to get back into form. We might have our chance to listen in.
On
the game behind Cymbalar's 22 points, Oscar's 11 is Will Artino with 9. He also has 9 rebounds, but that turnover count, the Lioneers already with 20.
First half, how you play? Outside, inside, ball move. You just boom, everybody catch.
Definitely getting the feeling that Coach Greg wants the Lioneers to play with a little bit more energy, a little bit more aggression on offense. Dribble penetration will create those opening passing lanes.
Bad screen. 出去. Oscar 进这边等. 四号位. 等. Wait. Under basket over here. 等Sim进来. 不要先跑. 等Sim到. 转出来. 一接. 一进去就结束了.
Well, causing those Lioneer turnovers, 5 steals by Johnson, 3 by Lai Ting-un. In total, the team has 13. While the Lioneers have out-rebounded them, those live ball turnovers are still creating great opportunities for the Braves to score and put pressure on the backcourt. I believe we're seeing some the family members of the Braves in attendance. Johnson sporting the short sleeve compression top provided by LP Support. Our great partners. As Jones pushes it in Sim's face, gets the bucket. Now Sim from the high post back to Tian Hao. Simple high screen and roll. Tian Hao leaves it short though. Dokwari left with the lane, down to Johnson who gets the foul. Well, more opportunities for the Braves now at the line. The Lioneers last season did not run hardly any sim pick and rolls for the first half of the season. And as you saw, it does create a lot of space for the Lioneers ball handlers. They only had some off-ball screening for Sim to try to body his way down low. It's taken a lot of his energy and was as easy as it is to defend Sim. But then Coach Greg and the staff started involving him in pick and roll situations in their winning ways and in the playoffs, and that became much harder. And so expect a little bit more of that here from the get-go as Sim has played into better playing shape to start the season. Arriving a little earlier, he was actually around for the interleague games as a spectator. Made 3 by Tian Hao, bringing the deficit to 10. Block shot easy. Sim against Tokoyu. Just as easy as having a cup of coffee if you're Sim Bular. down to Johnson, fumbled it, and loose ball on the floor. Look out. Looks like KJ able to pick it up. Running low on time. Perry Jones in and out with that three. A reload from Johnson. That's in. Back to a 13-point lead for the Braves. Playing straight up man defense. The double team comes and Sim able to get it in. Plenty of openings everywhere as Perry Jones misses. Beast right there in the middle. So the ball goes out of bounds. Right now, the Lioneers don't have a, haven't rotated hardly any guys in the second half. Run that cross screen for Sim. Jones comes over for the help. And that's kind of what happens when we don't have elite shooting on the outside and enough of them. Deep pass, lots of bodies in there. Jones flying to the rim. They call a foul at the point of contact. Kulosal Jid did a good job to even contest that. As perhaps Sim took a little bit of a beating there and amongst three defenders closing in on that pass. We haven't seen, I believe, Zhu Yinghao or Xiao Sunyi at all in the second half. Now on the evening, Perry Jones upping his point total to 17. As there we see is Zhu Yinghao coming in, now in his second season. In the finals, he was able to shoot around 37% from the field, but playing about 27 minutes per game. Not great spacing, and there's a foul on the drive by Beast or by KJ. We'll see. It is on Beast, and now the Braves will be putting the Lioneers at the free throw line every time. It's Kulosal Jid. A little bit from right to left on his free throws. That camera angle provided by our partners at Momo TV. Mimosa Television will get their shot at a broadcast, of course, for the third season now, down in Taizong for the Dreamers home opener. To KJ in the corner, his three is good. Easy driving kick by the Braves. Really picking apart the Lioneers. Martino steps up to a three and airballs it, and there's a rough foul from two guys, and we need to get the medics out to clean up some blood as we got a little head-to-head collision. Looks like both guys are not in too bad shape, but controlling the bleeding is definitely important. And a tricky thing whenever you have a head injury or head contact. Unfortunately for both guys, stitches might be needed after the game. We see Guo Xiaojie getting to the body, and the reason why this is a foul on the defense is because you need to allow the offensive player to catch and make a move down court. You can't ambush them with a blocking foul there, or that certainly makes basketball really hard to play if offensive players or rebounders or shooters can't turn around like that. Now, understandably, the brunt of the contact might have been felt by Guo Xiaojie. Timeout on the floor. The referees had a chance to look at it. Looks like just a common foul, but free throws coming up. It's kind of one of those unlucky situations there. Now, if it's just a matter of free throws, the Lioneers, 7 for 12, it's only 58%. Meanwhile, the Braves hit 12 of 15. That 5 points difference, still not enough to erase right now what is a 14-point difference. Though they have Sim Bular, the Lioneers only 15 for 38 from two-point range. Meanwhile, the Braves, 21 for 43. Only a 1-for-2 trip by Beast's substitute, I believe, Winston. Down low, and Winston got his hand in the cookie jar. Martino misses the strip, and now at 5-on-3, Winston gets himself into a corner. Now in the short corner, he's able to lay it in. Honestly, those are the shots that would freak me out the most. From the corner, no chance at hitting glass. Maybe a little bit too close to use a jumper. The foul by Josh Ogoyer on the pass. The referee is trying to keep control of the Braves bench, who had a front row seat to that one, literally. They'll send Sim Bular to line again, already 24 points. Hits the first one. Tokoyer so far with only one foul in the game. Still stuck on that 4-point mark. After a 2-for-2 trip, Sim Bular and Oscar still the only Lioneers in double digits. The Braves have four players as Jones misses. Martino get credit for that contest. Referees probably letting Josh off without giving a flopping technical there. 2 points to Martino, now he's got 11. Running low on time, Jones losing it against Martino. And from half court, Ryan floats it just short. But the Braves, on the strength of a 35-point third quarter, have now a commanding lead over the Lioneers as we head to the fourth and final frame of this Plus League opener.
好，来，现场被拍的朋友一起来跟 Steve 反方向，我们来来，对对对，跟他一起往中间指 ，One of One 富邦证券，没有别人，只有我们小朋友，来跟张文平哥哥一起往中间指哦。来，美女们一起跟着 Steve， 没错，往中间指。邀请所有现场的伙伴们。来来来，帅哥美女往你们的右手边，右手边，对对对对对，柠檬来跟 Steve 一起往你的右边指，没错，好，哎，右边右边，对对对，邀请所有现场的勇士伙伴们，小朋友右边右边，跟着 Steve 哥哥一起哦，卡卡换你咯，右边送飞吻也是可以，哎，小妹妹换你咯，帅哥帅哥，跟着 Steve 一起，你的右边，没错，小朋友很棒哦，很好，这位很嗨的小朋友一起
Some look at the faces in the crowd here at Taipei Hoping Gymnasium, including fan So Young that parents putting on some headphones to protect their hearing.
帅哥美女换你们喽，往右边右边，很好。
Well, Jet, Zhang Zhongxin is getting the highlight package as we head to the fourth quarter. So far on the game, number three, able to score a Braves high 21 points. He's doing that on 8 for 17 shooting. Doesn't have that many other stats to his name, but he's kind of letting his teammates take care of that.Right now, Chris Johnson working on a 20-10-5, almost five. Needs a couple more assists. Sun Xianjing's back in the game for the first time in a while. A step into this three, it's in! He hit a couple in the finals.I believe it was game three here in Hoping Gymnasium against the Lioneers, and that was a huge boost. Little jump pass, and Sim able to score. And the foul as well. Not nearly as much fanfare from the fans, of course, and didn't even hear anything from the Lioneers bench. A smart use of the jump pass, and...Good eye by the official from the trail position. Caught the arm point of contact foul. Jet switched on to Xiao Sun Yi. Ends up in the air and called for the travel. Not a horrible result for the Braves as...They don't want to have a live ball turnover. Well, that does it. They now have 12 turnovers, so something for Coach Roger and the staff to harp on the team about. Sim and Johnson, the imports for each team, as a layup is made by the left-handed Zhu Yunhao.Junior Hall out of Jinxing University. Has a couple of former teammates in the Braves between Chen Fan and Jian Tingzao, TJ. We'll get to see them maybe in a future day. Runner is too strong by Lai Tingen. Body bump by Johnson there. The Lioneers can still get back into it. You know, the plus league, anything could happen. And they've done it to previous teams before, including the Braves, as I mentioned, game one of the finals. Ryan, the Shaosui in the corner. They keep pushing around now. That's a shot clock violation. Everyone kind of just fell asleep there on the line near side. Nobody was ready to shoot. But we've been told that Beast is gash and presumably Guosaoji's gash is big enough that they need to spend a little extra care to stop the bleeding, maybe their emergency stitches there. Jet, Xiangjun from the left side, his three is too strong. In the regular season, the largest lead the Lioneers overcame was 18 points against the Kings. That was on April 17th. Xiaosui blocked from behind by Zhou Hui. Well, Zhou Hui, after getting a block from Sim, that one wasn't too difficult. The naturally left-handed Xiaosui kind of left it up right there for him. A botch play, and the Lioneers, again, lucky that was a dead ball turnover. Well, it's a 12-point deficit for the Lioneers, but they have not made much hay in this quarter. Xiaosui probably got away with a foul there. Zhen Xiangjun misses from the corner. Nice find, and Xiaosui able to finish. Pass by Ryan Lin Yihui. That makes it a total of 22 assists for the Lioneers. That's an air ball by the Braves. So here's your chance. Already got it to just 10 points. Yihui, but Sim missing the dunk. Have another chance. Xiaosui, left-handed hook is in, and the Braves immediately call timeout, sensing the flow going the other way. It also looked like they want to bring in a few subs, too. The fight, as we have just under 8 minutes to go in the opening game of the Plus League's third season.
这边有人想要吗？前面的朋友，这边不错。这边声音，B区的伙伴们，好，抱歉，歪了一点，换这边喽。好，我要找蓝色、黑色、白色的。 换中间了，sorry， 有点用力，最后两个了，谢谢各位。
You look at the capacity crowd here at Taipei Hoping Gymnasium. The Lioneers have made a little bit of a run to get back into the game. course, they started the quarter with Sim Bular, and I don't think it's really their intention to play him all 12 minutes of the final quarter. Quite a strain on his fatigue and energy levels. It looks like he'll be coming back in. The only players with foul trouble, or approaching foul trouble even, is Willie Martino with three fouls, Kuosawa Jay with three. There you see Artino bundled up there. Meanwhile, for the Braves, Perry Jones has got three fouls, and so does Ty Wen-Tun. And last year when I got to do a quick interview with Jones, he said, I asked him if any local players stood out. He said the captain, because he can get any kind of shot up and make it. Jones able to score on the follow-up. Not exactly an execution score, but just a good effort score. KJ jumps back and gets that one poked away. Numbers, but Jones dribbles it into a turnover. Chowsweeney has another chance. Left-handed lay, no good. As former teammates in Winston and Sim get a little tangled up. Have an off-ball foul there. Going to be the first for the Lioneers. I've said that before. Kind of interesting. It can work either way. Where a team that's down, you might want to have your full bonus fouls going on against the opponents to stop the clock, or you want to have very few fouls and maybe be aggressive. Jet getting to the rack, missing, and Jones with another follow-up. Boxing out, becoming a problem for the Lioneers. Got to play to the end and finish possession. Stuinghal, nice shot fake. Left-handed lay is good. That's on the scouting report. He can shoot it from deep range. Now if he can finish at the rim like that, he's going to be very, very good on the offensive side. Jones shoots in Artino's face, is in. Back to a 13-point lead, but 6 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Just like that, Jones is now topping the Braves in scoring. Hammer action, Leamy behind the back to Artino. Pretty move, can he finish? He can't with the right hand, smart. Pokes it to Winston. Got a size mismatch out there. Winston against Ling Mi. But it's KJ to the rim. Banks it on the underside. And now a 1-on-0 fast break. Good leak out by number three. Leamy has been with the Lioneers since the first season as he was signed partway through. Playing very briefly with the Chinese NBL League as Jones drains another three. Feeling himself. Smart there to help, and Xiaosui getting the foul on the fake. Brenda Smart caught helping a little bit too much. Couple made threes by Perry Jones the third. There's a make by Xiaosui as he was 0 for 2 in a previous trip. Now 27 points for Jones is only one behind Sim Bular for the lead of the game. Get 97-85. As the Braves want to have a much better opening game than they did last year, where they lost to the Dreamers after surrendering a 20-point lead. Jones trying to put on the dribble moves, throws it into a turnover. Doinghall spins and finishes through two. Incredible. He made it look easy, too. That's not his forte, but maybe we've seen the improvements that youngster has been making. So a 10-point game with 4:22 left on the clock and another another timeout. Coach Watcher reminding
his
guys to push the pace still.
传中线持球，在反挡的时候，假设没有人清开了，没有人你就上了。如果这边他帮忙边很多，阿提诺在这边真的用。如果这边你要跟凯杰同边哦，你被 deny 走掉，平挡凯杰上来，凯杰来用。中线 smart 在这边，所以切入 smart 的 help 再给他，不要让 smart 去处理球，让他投篮。好，防守 rebound， 我念 rebound， 来 go，
let's go，
对。
Looks like Kerry Jones might be getting a break, but after a couple tough putbacks and a couple threes on the outside, the big reason why the Braves were able to start with a lead in the fourth, of course, and expand on it. But now the Lioneers are starting to make their move, forcing some turnovers by the Braves and going in transition themselves. Gokwe is kind of running the point as Jet. Quick layup is in. Speeding around Willie Martino there. That brings his point total to 23. Zone defense by the Braves. Li Hui to the corner. Doinghall, his shot is in. Now a 9-point game. Waiting for the screen and out of bounds as Josh loses control over it. Give William Martino a little bit of credit there. Trying to make some room for Artino. Mimi drops it back for Doinghall. 5 seconds, four, to the corner. He's open, the three is up, and off the mark. Pretty good late clock execution by the Lioneers. They're not out of it yet. Under 3 minutes, still a three possession game. Right at the four, Jet's three is short. Zhao Sui stripped and maybe took a little bit of a bump as the ball was going out of bounds there. Getting a friendly hug from behind by Johnson. Wait up. you're getting introduced to Chris Johnson for the first time as a Plus League fan. Went to LSU. Born out of D.C. Leave Lee Mi open again. His three is on the way, and again off target. A couple good opportunities go the wayside. Yeah, with an agility advantage on Lee Mi, but now the switch. Xiao Sun Yi pokes it into a turnover. Martino bumps and throws the pass and flings it in for two. Good hand-eye coordination by the big man there. And now a seven-point game as Coach Rogers playing his younger guys along with Johnson and Jett. A little freedom of movement foul there by Xiao Sun Yi. It's a 7-point game, but once again, here's the math starting to work. 7-point game, only two team fouls. Smart flashes, takes the elbow jumper. Kind of faded his way out to a miss as Jett fouls on the rebound. Lioneers call timeout, probably to get the right rotation they want, maybe give their guys a little bit of a break. Let's see if they stick with their rotation of Martino, Zhu Yun Hao, Lee Mi, Xiao Sun Yi.
Ryan, 小弟. Yes.
Looks like they're calling me.
Okay. Will, 顺义, 可以吗? 所以第一个先这样挡, Ryan over here. 对第一个 feeling 如果有的话, 三号位哦, 可以吗? 如果没有, 在这边, team pull, 可以吗? 就直接走了, 所以这边 elevator, 可以吗? So now, okay, Ryan 没有接到球哦, 你就要出去咯, 好, now elevator, they will switch, they will switch, trust me. So, okay, 顺义, 他一出, they switch, 顺义, 100%, this way, boom. 你只要听到, 你只要听到 switch, yeah. 你只要听到 switch, 你就是进去。 所以这边没有出来, we are right here, 给他, okay. 所以一样, 所以这边没有, we will pop out, maybe, two, three, maybe hand off, hey, 小六到这个位置, drive, kick out, let's go.
Let's go, let's go.
Yeah.
Well, this is definitely a different strategy than the Lioners are used to, playing a guy at the high post, and that's kind of Will Artino's forte, as maybe he can take it in for a score up close, or he can shoot the three ball, of course, provide good screening action as the big body he is, he brings to the they'll be able to inbound from the front court. Minute 18 left. Elevator for Zhuyin Hao. And kind of lucky for every, I guess, for Lioneers. It was a dead ball turnover, but that trip, I think might want to take another look at that. Get a full look at that one there. So if Winston, my point is Winston diving on the ball, if he gets off of a pass and the Braves score, that pretty much is game over. Junior Hall commits the foul, but they gotta do it a couple more times. Sunshine Dreams in the game, not necessarily the best free throw shooter. As Jack fouled by Xiao Sunyi, and that's what we're talking about, the wrap around the waist. Is a foul that Plus League and certainly Taiwan referees have seen that go by plenty of times, but that's kind of a new point of emphasis that the referees are kind of talking about now in their referee rooms. Making his Plus League debut, maybe not in the most ideal circumstances. Zhen Boyu, technically a rookie, he's played a season at the SBL level. Kind of just trapping the Braves in the corner, who have horrible execution. And you get bailed out by a foul there. Now, there could really be a foul, but my point is, why would you do a handoff in the corner and restrict your dribbling? Winston was already occupying that spot. You don't want to bring another defender over. Crucial miss free throw there by Jet. Only one for two. Julian Hall going to the basket, but losing the handles, and it goes out of bounds. Say it's all his fault, but I guess he's the one who's gonna have the turnovers to his name. Playing a little keep away, Johnson to Zhen Xiangjun, who's well aware of the time. Jet with a bad miss, and Johnson to Winston, almost flinging it up for a score. They gotta execute perfectly, and Artino turns it over. Down the floor, Winston misses, and Zhen Xiangjun will put that finishing touch on the game. So down the stretch, a score by Li Yinghui, and looks like that will be the end of the game. Time's up, and 102-94 is the final as the Braves take game one of our 120-game odyssey for season three of the Plus League. Yeah, strong third quarter pretty much put away the Lioneers, who showed good adjustments in the second quarter. And it certainly showed pretty strong togetherness in the end, but a little bit too little too late. Of course, our broadcast partner Lin Jiayi will be on hand for the post-game interview as the players, perhaps for the first or only maybe just second time, depending on pre-game scrimmages, seeing each other. The former Brave Sim Bular, of course, having some friendly goodbyes.
好，现场的满场，七千名的球迷们，大家晚安，真的非常开心，勇士在开季首胜102-94拿下了胜利，当然功臣哦，非常重要的就是嘉义场边访问到的就是台湾喷射机张忠宪，是不是先跟大家做个打声招呼？就是球迷朋友，就是你们等很久，然后现在我们 赛季开始了，希望后面就是可以大家进场，就是多支持富邦勇士，谢谢。
Thank you, everybody, for coming and encouraging the Braves.
希望他们都是很好的球员，然后 work with the two imports who they don't have as much experience with. But Jet saying, those are guys who are easy to work with, so they trust their preparations and they got the result they wanted.
其实可以说是表现大爆发哦，单场是拿下了24分，是不是有什么想要在开幕战的这场比赛告诉你的球迷？
就是对我来说，自己的表现其实不重要。
Jet saying his personal performance, including 24 points, not as important as the team result.
当然希望勇士可以如中宪所说的拿下三连霸。谢谢中宪，谢谢。好，当然也很感谢收看 Plus League 2022-23球季的大家，也希望大家可以享受接下来的所有比赛。
We'll go to break.
谢谢大家，就是进场看球，然后有你们支持，我们一定可以就是做得更好，然后拿下三连霸，谢谢。
谢谢，来，马上请宪哥来签球，我们要抽送出四颗签名球，以后只要赢球都有球可以拿。待会再请宪哥来投出，记得拿出你的热情，让他知道丢向哪里。好，宪哥就可以帮我送出你的签名球。好，我们这边也可以哦，都可以，每一区都帮我照顾一下，热情热情。再一次掌声送给张宗宪，张宗宪，张宗宪，
张宗宪。
谢谢各位，好的，也很开心，在今天勇士就在11月5号，我们开幕战就拿下胜利，当然也要很感谢今天进场的大家，那么也谢谢大家跟着我们 BUNI 应援团队，还有我们的富邦 Angel 比尔一起来为勇士加油。明天是第二天，明天是第二天的开幕周，也希望大家明天都要进场。明天我们要送给各位跟勇士一模一样设计的冠军戒指，在这边邀请大家一起来到台北和平篮球馆，所有的勇士伙伴们，谢谢大家，大家晚安，拜拜。谢谢。
Tomorrow, the Kaohsiung 1-7 Live Steelers, with their brand new look, will be taking on these very Braves here at Taipei Hoping Gymnasium. I'm Ryan Chen. Thank you so much for joining this English broadcast of Plus League Basketball as we get another look at our handsome Mandarin broadcast duo. Also, shout out to Iguchi-san, doing the Japanese broadcast for a special opening day collaboration between us and the B-League. Despite not playing some of the imports they're more familiar with, Chris Johnson and Perry Jones provided, of course, good individual scoring, but also work really well with their teammates in their defensive scheming. And when you have Jet step up for 24 points, that's also really big for them as they're able to take this first victory. Now on the line near side, they perhaps saw the deficit go as much as, if I remember correctly, 18 points. But they did claw back to make it a game a little bit in the end. And maybe you wonder about the rotations, but then Coach Greg has a plan for the entire season, no matter if it comes to Sim or the other imports, and of course how they develop their local players. Well, on behalf of our league colleagues and the six teams, thank you for watching. We'll see you guys in the next one.